Hi everybody, today I want to talk to you about how to survive a long fast. I don't want to talk to you about the spiritual sides of fasting. I've done that in another video, and I've done that in a lot of my teaching on our church's website at churchofgrace.com. But today I want to just share with you about how do you survive a 3-day, 5-day, 10-day, 15-day, 21-day, or a 30-day fast. And you might be thinking to yourself, it's an awful lot of food right in front of you. You're going to be talking about fasting. And I would like to share with you how you can make it through a very long fast. First of all, I'd like you to know that I'm well experienced in fasting. I have countless number times of fasting one day, many, many 3-day fasts, quite a few 5, a bunch of 10s. I have fasted 15 days numerous times. My 21-day fast, I have done quite a few times. In fact, in a couple of weeks, my wife Suzette and I are going to be starting our second 21-day fast just in this calendar year. So I have fasted 25 days, I have fasted 28 days, I have fasted 30 days twice. I have fasted many different times throughout my career of being in the ministry, which at the time of this video has been 37 years. When I was in my 20s, which I'm not right now, but when I was in my 20s, I would fast and I would only use water. And that's this item right here. And I cannot stress enough that you should be drinking and sipping water all day long while you're fasting. And you may say, well, gee, then I'd have to go to the bathroom a lot. So what? Flush all that toxin out of your body, but drink water. Drink lots and lots and lots and lots of water. As I said, when I was in my 20s, I did a 21-day fast just on water, nothing else but water. And it wasn't difficult at all. If you're able to go on your fast, whether it's 1 day, 3 day, 5 day, 10 day, 15 day, 21 day, if you can do it with just water, praise God, go do it. As I have gotten older, I have found that my body has reacted differently, and I've had to adjust how I fast. The goal of fasting is to slow your body down. The goal of fasting is not to prove I can go X number of days with no food. The goal of fasting is to get you into this spiritual place, this calm that overwhelms you, and the world cannot shake it. The goal of fasting is for you to be calm enough and relaxed enough on the inside where there's enough of your body slowing down and relaxing that you're able to hear the voice of God. And when you read the Bible, it means something to you. You gain spiritual benefits from fasting. Now, in my body metabolism, when I fast, it doesn't matter if I was in my 20s or right now, which I'm about 8 months away from my 60th birthday. Whenever I fast, I lose an average of 1 pound a day. Doesn't matter if I do 3 days, 5 days, 10 days, or 30 days. I lose a pound a day. In a 21-day fast, I'll lose anywhere from 20 to 25 pounds. I am not doing it for the purpose of losing weight. I am not doing it for the purpose of trying to get in a certain place of my weight. Those are just things that happen. And you can, if you like to lose 10 pounds during a fast, then that's a side benefit from it. But what I want to talk to you about is surviving through a fast. So let's first talk about a one-day fast. Let's talk about a one-day fast. On a one-day fast, you're going to wake up in the morning, and you're not going to have any food, and you're going to go to bed that night with no food. The next day you wake up, you're going to start having some food. That's no big deal. Anybody in America can do a one-day fast. You're not going to die. What you want to do in your one-day fast is drink lots and lots and lots of water. Just drink water. That's it. For a one-day fast, it's a breeze. You drink a bunch of water. You go to prayer. When you're hungry, you pray. When it's a mealtime, you go pray. Whenever you think that you were supposed to be eating, you go pray. If you do not add prayer to your day, then you're just dieting. And that's not going to help you spiritually. Because if dieting helped people spiritually, then America would be one of the most spiritual countries in all the world. Now, let's talk about a longer fast instead of a one-day fast, a 3-day fast. On a 3-day fast, it's going to be a little different. And on all your fasts, there's something I'd like to share with you. If you have the ability to cut out and cut down on caffeine, sodas, and some other items before your fast, it's better if you can do that. If you drink a lot of coffee, if you have a lot of caffeine in your body, you drink a lot of soda or other kind of power drinks that have a lot of caffeine, then you are going to have some physical reaction to it. You're going to go through some caffeine withdrawals. Usually it's a very bad headache. And if you have a horrible headache during your fast, then take some kind of pain reliever for your headache, okay? Just take some Advil or Tylenol or something like that, you know, whatever that might be. But you can get rid of the headache. The headaches are usually gone after the second day. I've had some people tell me they didn't get a headache until the third day. But don't worry about that part of it and those kind of things. But if you can cleanse your body out with water, it's real good. So let's say you're doing a three-day fast. On a three-day fast, what you want to do, again, is drink a lot of water. Drink plenty of water. But you might have a few times where you have hunger pains. Now, do understand, everyone, especially those in America, in the United States, North America, when you have hunger pains, you're not starving. It's just your body saying, I crave something, I want something. The average North American could go for 30 days without any food and not going to lose anything except some weight. So don't think, oh, I'm starving. No, because you're not starving yet. But you are going to be discomforted by those pains, that your hunger and those kind of things. And I need to do a timeout, pause right now. If you're a diabetic, if you are have any kind of medical conditions that might prevent you from fasting, please check with your doctor and find out how you can fast for you with your doctor. What I'm referring to is you may have to have some level of nutrition input in your body, but you still probably could reduce your intake quite a bit and still enter the state of fasting. Our goal is to be in the state of fasting, that calmness, that slowing down of the body, that where the body's also been flushed out of its toxins, and now you are relaxed, easier. The things of the world don't overwhelm you. The problems that are in your life don't hound your brain, and that's what I call the state of fasting, where you enter into the presence of the Lord, you enter into the state of the Lord. So if you are fasting for 3 days, as we're talking about, one thing that you may want to do is, besides having water, you can add some lemon slices to your water just to help in your mouth get rid of some of that yucky taste that you might have from fasting. It also help cleanse your body and just make the water taste a little more flavorful and a lot more fun. The other thing that you can do is on the time when you're facing some tough hunger pains is you can do something like this. This is naked juice that you can get at pretty much any grocery store, and it has a blend of vegetables and fruits in it. So you could have a couple glasses of this throughout the day, a couple times during the day. Takes away some of that hunger pain, maintaining your fasting state. The other thing you can also do is add some apple juice. You could sip on apple juice throughout the day or have a 50-50. That's 50% apple juice, 50% water, and dilutes the apple juice. What I have found when you use any kind of citrus juice like orange juice or something, it's a little hard on my stomach. It doesn't agree with me. So I stay away from that. I found apple juice to be very helpful. Those are the times where you're feeling hungry. You're feeling like, oh, or you're feeling a little weak and you just have a little shot of some juice. A little shot of some vegetable juice or something, and you're able to go in there. Oh, also, the other thing would be, I've had some people tell me they've had great success using Gatorade a couple times during the day, during each day of their fast. Now, what I'd like to talk to you about is a longer period of fasting. If you are going to do a 5 day, 3 to 5 day fast, just what I said, that will work on a 3 to 5 day fast. If you're going to go to a 10 day fast, you could probably do that. Now, if you're going to go to 12, 15, 20, 21 day, 30 day fast, and it's hard for you just to have water, or it's hard just to have water and juice, there's a way that you can get into a state of fasting that works really well. I've done this a couple of times. I'm going to be doing this on our 21 day fast where our church every September gathers together. We do a 21 day prayer and fasting time. And what I do is on the first several days, like for an example, you're going 21 days, you want to make it long. The goal is not to go without food. The goal is to pray. The goal is not to abstain from food. The goal is to pray. The goal is not to See how little food I can eat. The goal is to be in that state of fasting. And if you are in that state of fasting, then you are achieving your goal. And I have found that you can get into that state of fasting and move in there slowly and then stay in it for a period of time and then move out of it again slowly. For an example, let's take a 21-day fast. You want to do a 21-day fast. I would recommend that you pare down, that you taper down the first 5 days. You're going to have 5 or 6 days where you are going to taper down. And so here's what I have done in order to do that, to taper down. I drink a lot of water with lemon in it. I have some apple juice throughout the day as feeling any kind of tiredness or hunger. And I also have found that when you get into day 5, 6, 7, that the hunger pains go away and another level of strength comes. There's some pretty amazing things that happen. I have used Nega juice as well. This is the Green Machine. I particularly like this one. I've used it like once or twice a day in the morning, in the evening, just so that you have some level of energy, you're able to continue to do your workload, your workday. I have had Gatorade. I'm not sure if I was a big fan of it or not, but I've had some other people tell me that it's worked really well for them, especially if you started having leg cramps in the middle of your fast because of the lack of potassium or magnesium and some other things. So this can be helpful there. On a long fast, here's what I would recommend. You're going on a 21-day fast, you're going to taper down, and you are going to the first 5 or 6 days, you're going to have some vegetables. You're going to have just vegetables only. So I would say the first 4 or 5 days, you can chomp on carrots throughout the day, whenever you want to, as much as you want in that sense, because you're just eating some carrots and they're going to go out of your system real fast, or some cucumbers. Found out you slice the cucumbers up, they turn into water really quick in your body, in your system. They give you a little bit of energy. They help you. And what we're doing is we're spending 5 days tapering down. If someone there is watching this video and say, well, that's not fasting. You're still having food. What our goal is, the goal is the state of fasting. The goal is prayer. The goal is the presence of the Lord. And I have found this time of my life, as I said, in the 20s, I would just do water only. But now I found my body's a little different, and this has worked really well for me and put me in the state of fasting really, really well. So here's what I do the first 5 days. I would chomp on some cucumbers and carrots and maybe some celery throughout the day when I felt hungry and I just wanted to get rid of that hunger pain. But then once a day at night, I made a vegetable tray. And what I would do, I would use like asparagus. This is zucchini or some bell peppers. You know, getting some peppers. I would slice them, put them on a tray like this. I would pour olive oil on them, just brush them with some olive oil and salt and pepper. Threw them in the oven, baked them in the oven, and then I would eat that. I would eat it once a day. That would be like somewhere around the dinner time, but throughout the day, I've increased my prayer time. I've increased the presence of the Lord. I've increased my water intake. I've got some apple juice. I've got something else that's helping me, and I would do that for the first 5 days. Now, come day 6 or 7, I start leaving all of this completely, going to just juice and water, and maybe once a day, a little bit of Green Machine. And then what would happen is I would be there for probably 10 to 15 days. Now I'm going to come on out of that. So I've got, let's just say, you've got anywhere from 5 to 7 days you're doing this. Then you're going to go anywhere from 9 to 7 days with nothing but water and this, because your body has gotten used to fasting. It's slowing down. And then I'm going to take the last 5 days and introduce a little bit more with some more vegetables and start chewing on some celery or cucumbers or carrots throughout the day, adding that vegetable tray once a day for the next several days, then coming out of it. Then when I'm breaking my fast, that last day and the end of the day, I'm going to go to something a little small. You just can't jump into a steak, guys. You just can't do that. Your stomach is shrunk. Your body's not used to that. I'd go into something else like some chicken broth or some soup or some tomato soup. Oh, and that's another item that I used throughout my last 21-day fast. I got some V8. And once a day, I took a can of V8, heated it up, and sipped on it. just sipped on it. And when you haven't had any food for 10 days, that is just heavenly. But what it did is gave me enough energy to keep on going. I have found that method for that 21 days to work really, really well for me, but you have to experiment what works for you. The goal is the state of fasting. The goal is prayer time. The goal is to hear the voice of God, and the goal is to grow spiritually. God, blessings on you and your fasting, and I hope this has been beneficial to you.